Hi, my name is Preeti Thyparampil. I am an associate professor of ophthalmology at Feinberg School of Medicine at Northwestern University and an oculoplastics and reconstructive surgery specialist at Northwestern Ophthalmology. I'm going to talk to you today about a case challenge of a large orbital fracture. This was a very nice patient who presented to me after unfortunately being randomly assaulted on the CTA. She had been assaulted and immediately felt incredible pain around her eye area, had a lot of swelling and a lot of pain when she tried to look around. She was taken to the emergency room where orbital imaging was done. And we have some images of a CT scan of her orbit that if you look on the inferior part of her orbit, you'll see a large fracture of her orbital floor. The orbit is the bony cavity that surrounds the eyeball and supports the eye and the ocular structures like the extraocular muscles and the optic nerve. And the floor of the orbit is what the orbital contents, the eye and all of its associated structures, what they stand on, kind of like we would stand on a floor. And when the floor is broken, then the orbital contents can fall into the maxillary sinus below. And you can see that quite dramatically. And we have another scan looking a little further posteriorly or a little further back in her orbit. And you can see how her extraocular muscles, which surround the eyeball, have fallen significantly into her maxillary sinus. And that explains her symptoms, which were extreme pain when she tries to look around because all of those contents that have fallen into the sinus are being tugged on and are inflamed as they're fallen down in there and stuck inside the fracture. She also had double vision because when you have one eye that's sitting in one spot where it should be, another eye that's shifted down because it's no longer supported, then you see one image here and one image here and you see double. And that's very difficult to function with when you see two of everything. So she was very uncomfortable, having a lot of trouble functioning with her double vision and with her pain. Not all fractures need to be repaired. Small orbital fractures that are not causing the eye to shift or causing double vision that are not causing the orbital contents to be stuck can be allowed to heal on their own. But this was a large one that was causing all of the above mentioned problems and needed to be repaired. So she went to the OR with me and we did an orbital fracture repair with an implant placement. She required a rather large implant to bridge the defect of her orbital floor. So basically reconstructing the orbital floor to support her eyeball and extraocular contents. And initially that involves carefully dissecting and repositioning all of the orbital contents that have fallen into the maxillary sinus and moving them back into the orbit and then measuring out the size of the defect, which was sizable in her case, and placing an implant. And depending on the size of the defect, I'll place a particular type of implant. In her case, since it was a rather large defect, she had a titanium plate that was wrapped in MedPor and fixated in place with a few titanium screws along the cheek of her kind of anterior part of her orbit or the front part of her orbit. The recovery is a few weeks from this type of surgery. And there is double vision during the recovery period because of all the swelling, but she did great. Once all of that recovered, she was seeing single again. Fortunately, the injury did not cause her any eyeball injury. So she still had 20/20 vision. She no longer had double vision. She was able to look around without having pain, and her appearance was restored.